Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am doing spectacularly, and I thank you for asking. This is Ask Dotto Tech, the show where you ask questions and I answer them, often accurately. Today we're going to be returning to Gmail, and I'm going to show you a very useful technique to be able to bring other email accounts into your Gmail so that you can answer all of your email from a single interface. We're actually going to integrate Yahoo Mail with Gmail. It's cool, it's simple, and it is useful. We're going to be taking a look at Sunrise Calendar a little bit, which is really one of my favorite calendar apps, but we're going to be showing how to integrate that and sync it with Evernote. We've got questions on that. Plus, we're going to be spending some time with password managers. I've shown you a lot in my videos in the past how to use password managers to manage accounts, to manage your online access to accounts. But password managers will do a lot more protecting your personal information, but keeping it at your fingertips. So beyond using them just for your web accounts. That's all coming up today on Ask Dotto Tech. This is a big day for us on Ask Dotto Tech because we are bringing our first real sponsor to the table. The folks at Blocklist have decided that Ask Dotto Tech is an awesome product and they want to sponsor us, which is great because I think Blocklist is an awesome product. What is Blocklist? Blocklist is a service that allows us to do regional domain name switching. What the heck are you talking about, Steve? It allows me in Canada to watch US Netflix, which is phenomenal. We all know that Netflix in the US is better than Netflix in Canada. They just have better shows. This allows me to view those shows, and yes, it's legal. Yes, it's safe, and yes, it's simple. They're a Canadian-based company, and I think they are terrific, so I'm thrilled to bring them on board. Now, this works for everybody. If you happen to live in the States and you love British television, you want more British TV, you can access UK Netflix. If you speak German and you miss all those German televisions, well, guten Tag. It's good news for you because you can watch German Netflix regardless of where you happen to live. Any country, it allows you to regionally switch. It costs about $5 a month. I want you to check them out. They are at dottotech.com/Blocklist. dottotech.com/Blocklist is the place to go. Very excited. Welcome aboard, folks, at Blocklist. By the way, they're a good Canadian company as well. So, we're going to start things off by looking at Gmail. And we have a question from Agatha Melvin who says, thank you, Steve. She's referring to a previous episode of Ask Dotto Tech. Did I hear you correctly? You can also have your Yahoo accounts flow into your main Gmail account? Yes, Agatha, you heard me correctly. We were talking in a previous episode about how convenient it is to collect all of your different email accounts and have them and be able to manage them through Gmail. And a lot of people don't recognize that they can have other, even competitive accounts, Hotmail, Microsoft Mail, Yahoo Mail accounts, and they can manage it, send and receive all from within Gmail. And I thought I better show you how to do that. So I've got my demo Gmail account open here, and I'm going to show you how to integrate a Yahoo account. Shall we do that? And like most things that we do in Gmail, we're going to start right underneath the settings, the little gear icon there, and we're going to go into settings. And in settings, you're going to find this tab here, which is accounts and import. When we go into accounts and import, the link that we want to click on is add a POP3 mail account. Don't worry about the word POP3. Just think about it as add a mail account. Now, I've set up a demo Yahoo account just moments ago. So here it is right here. I'm going to put in the email address for it right here. It's dottotechdemo@yahoo.com. So now you go next step. So you put in your email address, and then you have to put in the password for that email address. For the most part, Google is going to look for standard internet convention as far as putting in the POP server and all of that sort of stuff. And for most webmail services, it's going to work just fine with their presets. Once that is done, we say add account. And it says the account has been added. I want to be able to send mail at that. So this is a key. So what you were setting up here is making sure that not only can we receive mail, but you can also send mail under that particular email account's address. That's something that you're definitely going to want to do. So we go to the next step. And it asks me to enter the name information about that account. We have to enter the email address now, not for just receiving, but for sending. And it will go through and it will check all of the credentials. Okay, so the final step in the process is a verification email was sent. Now, they actually send this verification email to the address which you are going to be incorporating into Gmail. So I'm going to go over now into my Yahoo email, and we see already here is a brand new email from Gmail itself. It says Gmail confirmation, send email, and so it's asking if I want to do this. So you can read your way through this, but essentially what you have to do is we have to click on this link here, which now verifies that I want to be able to send and receive email from this account in my Gmail account. So now what I want to do is I want to prove that we've done this properly. So I'm going to just quickly compose an email. I know it's going to come from the same email address, but I'm going to send an email to dottotechdemo@yahoo.com, and I'll just call it a test. Test or twist test. And we will send that. Now, we should theoretically get that in both this Yahoo account here. If we were to go back in and check in the inbox here, it should be arriving here because there it is. There's the test, right? Let's go back into our Gmail account, and there's the test there. So we can see it in our Gmail account. Now, if you don't want to go through this process of being able to, and it's not important for you to be able to send email from within Gmail, if you just want to be able to audit and have all of the email come in, an option for you to do is to instead set up auto forwarding from whichever account you want. So you just go into the settings of whatever email account you want to have sent to your Gmail account, and you set it up to automatically forward all email in. The only thing you lose is the ability to send email from that account in the future from within your email account. You'd have to go back into that original account in order to send email under that address. Does that all make sense? Agatha, I have to thank you so much for the question. Next up, we have a question from Murad, who says, "Hi, Mr. Steve." Well, hello, Mr. Murad. "I just get ToDoist, or you just got ToDoist, and find it's possible to sync tasks from ToDoist and to Sunrise. But sometimes he creates a task in Sunrise, and he wants it in ToDoist, and it's not there." At least I think that's exactly what he's saying. But I think that's a great question, because our tools like our calendar apps, we really want to make sure that they integrate with other services. That's one of the reasons that I like Sunrise Calendar so much, is it has wonderful integration with a variety of services. So let's jump over and have a quick look at it. Now, Sunrise Calendar is my calendar of choice. We've done demos on it. I'll put a link to a nice demo that I did on Sunrise Calendar here. But it's almost like what we were just looking at with Gmail, as far as it's a unified calendar that kind of is an umbrella organization for all of the other calendars in our lives. So when you install Sunrise Calendar and set it up, and it's free, you can then, if you go under the gear settings, as is always the case with our demos right now, going into those settings, if we go into accounts, we get an idea for exactly what Sunrise Calendar integrates with. So we can bring in our Google Calendar, our Office 365, our Outlook calendars, we can bring in iCloud. We can also bring in things that aren't necessarily pure calendars, but are event-based, things like Facebook birthdays and other things like that. These are all of the different services that Sunrise Calendar integrates with. Isn't that an amazing list? And these are the tools that I use on a daily basis that I have integrated with Sunrise Calendar. We can see that I have ToDoist and Evernote and Asana, as well as, of course, my Google Calendar. So let me show you how that integration ends up playing out when we add an event or we add a task in ToDoist. So now ToDoist isn't necessarily the best place for us to be putting in calendar events. It's a task manager. But sometimes we want those tasks to appear in our calendar. So let me jump over to my ToDoist account, and I'm just going to create a new task. I'm going to quickly add a task, and I'm going to call it something important. Important. There we go. Something important. Now, it doesn't have a due date, but I'm going to put it in for tomorrow. I'm going to put it in as a task for tomorrow. And I spelled something wrong. So let me fix that, because we can't have that going out on a now sponsored version of Ask Dotto Tech. So I'm going to add that task. So now I've added a task for tomorrow. I've created a date for the task. Now, it takes it a second for everything to sync through, but I'm just going to refresh ToDoist to make sure that it's refreshed and synced, and then I'm going to go over into Sunrise Calendar. Now, we should see momentarily our new task appearing in Sunrise Calendar. And what's happened now is ToDoist will sync to the web services, and then here it's already come through. So it's syncing its all of its stuff through the web services. The web services know that there's a conduit to Sunrise Calendar, and so that task is now passed through to Sunrise Calendar, so now it's in our calendar. And if I click on it, we can see that it's in ToDoist. It tells us that it's actually something in ToDoist, and if I click on View in ToDoist, I'm brought through to that task. So really nice integration between multiple services. Now this works not just with ToDoist, but with Evernote, a variety of other task to-do list and calendaring apps. And finally, we have a question from Anna, who says, I downloaded both Dashlane and LastPass to test them both before I pick one for my organization. I would like my PM to be able to log into not just websites for my team, but also computer programs like software we use for our help desk and our auditing wizard, etc. And so there, she is finding that neither of these services automatically help logging in to things other than websites. And yes, none of the password managers that I know will do those things, will log in to other types of services other than web-based services. Having said that, there is some capability that I wanted to share with you and show you within LastPass, which I think you might find interesting. And that is this. Let me open my LastPass account. And if we take a look at LastPass, we've got here the ability to obviously save sites, but they have an area called Secure Notes, which I think is well worth looking into. And when we click on Add a New Secure Note, what that does is it allows us to create secure information in LastPass that is not just logins to different websites. Look at the different things that they will automatically create, or you can just make kind of a blank file, but you can save a bank account, a credit card information, your driver's license. If you want to save your driver's license number and have it available to you, it's right there. All of these different types of data you can save in LastPass. Now I'm going to create a link here to a demo that we did on using LastPass, but it's the password manager that I use to protect all of my personal information. Now, the benefit of having this information in LastPass is if you have your smartphone with you and you're out and about and maybe you don't have your wallet and your driver's license and somebody says, what's your driver's license number? Because you're doing something that you require it for, you can go into your LastPass account on your smartphone and retrieve that information. You've got the information available for you when you need it and where you need it. So this is something that's well worth adding to the type of information that you're adding to your password manager. And other password managers will do this as well. It doesn't do exactly what Anna was looking for as far as helping to log in to, say, vertical applications, but you could store the password and login information in a secure note that the manager could then go into, they could into the note, and they could copy and paste the information into the appropriate fields. It's not quite as elegant, but it still serves the main purpose. And that, I think, brings us to an end. Remember, dottotech.com is brought to you by our new sponsor. Yes, indeed. I invite you to drop by and visit our friends at Blockless. Oh, where are they there? There we are, Blockless, at Blockless. That way you can view Netflix from around the world from the comfort of your own country. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.